is more reasonable? The blood alcohol content. Okay. Richard Doody was drunk. He was in his own home. He was retired. He wasn't driving a motor vehicle. You heard about the fact that his car hadn't been on the road for a while, I believe, from Detective Mazzella. He was at home enjoying his retirement. He was hanging out with his friend. Isn't it just as reasonable, I submit to you more so, that Rich Doody, with a 0.252 blood alcohol content, 3 times the legal limit, was in no position to attack anyone? As we see from the evidence, wasn't in a position to defend himself. These, I submit, defensive wounds are the only ones we see. Because he was intoxicated. Because after the first couple of blows, with the weapons available to the defendant that day, he couldn't defend himself at all. How about the defendant's injuries? Does it look like he was in a major fight? Much was made of, there's no documentation of the injuries to the back of his head. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a scale ruler to a cut on his pinky. There was a scale ruler, you'll have all these photos and evidence, to the, I'm sorry, what did Janet Johnson call them? The tiny abrasions to his fingers. Is it reasonable that if the defendant presented with injuries to the back of his head, that those weren't photographs? Are we hiding evidence? No. I submit to you, multiple witnesses testified that scenes were processed thoroughly. This defendant was processed, by the way. You have those photos to demonstrate that. Small injuries were documented with a scale. Why would they ignore something like that? He didn't exist. They weren't there. These are not the injuries of someone fighting for his life. So you hurt me. Have the opportunity to have it with you. Tampering with physical evidence. That the defendant believed an official proceeding was about to be instituted. We can't know what's in a person's head. That knowledge element is often circumstantial. But I submit to you the actions of this defendant between November 21st and November 25th demonstrate nothing but the fact that he knew this. We can know that. It's inherent in his behavior. This was not the behavior of someone who, in the heat of the moment, created this horrible act. It was purposeful conduct. And he purposely destroyed, concealed, or removed multiple objects or things from 2204 Central Avenue. The label. The beer bottles, the magnets. Where's the cell phone? Where's the victim's iPad? We know he removed those physical things. What else did he take? And that his purpose in destroying or concealing them was to impair their availability in the investigation. Again, I point to the victim's phone. The victim's iPad. Wouldn't you like to know? Heard that from the defense. Wouldn't you like to know what was on the victim's phone? What was on the victim's iPad? Me too. It was taken from the crime scene. I submit to you the circumstantial evidence overwhelmingly demonstrates by this defense. So that we couldn't know. So that we couldn't see. So that it couldn't be used against him. Hindering. Again, that he knew that he could or might be charged with homicide. He knew he did this. His attorney should have told you this is a case of self-defense. swipe on the wall, the trash in his garage, and that he acted for the purpose to hinder his own detention, apprehension, investigation, prosecution, conviction, or punishment. I submit to you, ladies and gentlemen, the state is satisfied all three of those elements. Why else would he take that light bulb from 2204 Central Avenue? Why else? Unlawful possession of a weapon. S95A, it's a weapon. It's a knife. It has a lawful purpose. I believe John Bartowski called it a meat knife. It's a weapon. I think we can all agree. But that he possessed it knowingly, I submit to you, it's difficult to hold a knife without knowing that you're holding it. And that his possession was under circumstances not manifestly appropriate for lawful use. That knife was the cause of the injuries to Rich Doody's neck. That knife caused the injury that was likely that single cause of death. Swallowing his own blood. I submit to you the state has proved each element of that charge beyond reasonable. Possession of these weapons for an unlawful purpose. That S95A is a knife. 93A in the other part of the golf club, 94A. It's also a weapon. Obviously, a golf club has a lawful purpose. But was it used lawfully in this case? Into you, the proof dictates it was not. It was in that bucket, the bloody paper towels, and we know this defendant cleaned up the scene and the lamp. This lamp, both pieces of this lamp, it's heavy. Janet Johnson told you that. S90A. Edges are sharp. Janet Johnson told you this lamp make a pretty good weapon. I submit to you the state has proven that each of those implements can be used as a weapon to inflict serious bodily injury. That he possessed the weapon. We can't show you what we don't have. Was his DNA on that knife? No. Was the defendant's DNA on the golf club? Is there any blood staining on this golf club? No. Why? I submit to you, it was wiped down. How about the lamp? His fingerprints on a label. I submit to you, this is not conjecture or speculation. It is proof beyond a reasonable doubt. This defendant held each of these weapons. He possessed them. And then he possessed them with the purpose to use them unlawfully against Rich Doody in this case. We know the knife is the cause of those injuries. We know the lamp has impacts that are all over it. The golf club is in the bucket, the bloody ceramic pieces, and the bloody paper towels. I submit to you the only reasonable conclusion is that he possessed them to use them against Rich Doody. And that his purpose was to so use them. What other purpose do you have, ladies and gentlemen, when you take an item and you swing it repeatedly at someone's head? Not lawful. That satisfies the elements of possession of these weapons for an unlawful purpose. And murder. stepped down and killed his friend. But sometime that night, between the last text message and 5 o'clock, and when this defendant makes the Tom's River toll at 12:35 a.m., something went wrong, and he committed murder. Caused Rich Judy's death, or that he caused the serious bodily injury that resulted in his death. I submit to you, reviewing the evidence as a whole, there can be no doubt about that. That he did so purposely or knowingly, again, not that he plotted this, that he planned this release. He went to see his friend and something happened. We cannot prove to you why. No one's ever hidden that from you. It's not an element, it's human nature. But what does the evidence show you? This wasn't an accident. Rich Doody didn't slit his own throat. I submit to you, there was no struggle over the knife. Rich Doody sat in that chair struck over the head repeatedly, and then when one weapon failed, he stopped and he went maybe to the kitchen and he got another weapon and he stood over his friend and he finished the job. That's the intent, that's the purposeful and knowing element of this murder. I submit to you the evidence in this case leads you to that reasonable conclusion. And he did not act in the heat of passion, resulting from a reasonable provocation. I submit to you also, this was not self-defense. He had no other choice. He had every opportunity along the way to make a number of different choices. When one weapon failed, was the victim standing? Jan Johnson told you he wasn't. He was in that chair. He wasn't getting up. It was over. The defendant didn't walk away. He got another knife. He got another weapon. He got the knife. He cut his friend's throat. Dr. Hood talked about sawing. Talked about how deep that knife went. It's right there. We'll have it for your review. How he cut himself, ladies and gentlemen, how the defendant get that wound on his pinky? Was that in self-defense? Or Jan Johnson told you, could have been from all the ceramic pieces. You'll see the sharp edge of that lamp. Could it have also been when he held this knife? It has no grip. It has no sturdy handle. It's one piece. I submit it's probably slippery at that point. Is it more reasonable that he cut himself during the cleanup, during the course of stabbing his friend in the neck? What's more reasonable? Passion is not proof, ladies and gentlemen. But there is not proof of passion and provocation. Was he angry? Probably. Can we speculate? Can we have conjecture? Defense told us not to. What do we know? This is murder. I submit to you proof beyond a reasonable doubt that this defendant purposely, knowingly, sometime on November 21st into the early morning hours of November 22nd. And I submit to you, when you have all of this evidence, this physical evidence that sits in front of you, those photographs, when you recall the testimony of the witnesses, this defendant is the one who committed it. And I ask you, when you go into that jury room after you've received the judge's instructions, that you take those elements, that picture, in front of that puzzle box, and that you put those pieces together in the way that you